Hey, good afternoon, students. Today I am going to explain the problems related to cross product. If x bar cross b bar equal to c bar cross b bar, and x bar dot a bar is 0, then x bar equal to x bar cross b bar equal to c bar cross b bar, and x bar dot a bar equal to 0, then x bar equal to. Here x bar cross b bar equal to c bar cross b bar implies x bar cross b bar minus c bar cross b bar equal to 0 bar, because this is a vector and this is a vector. Hence we can write x bar minus c bar cross b bar is 0 bar, because cross product is distributive with respect to either vector addition or vector subtraction. So the cross product of these two vectors is 0. The cross product of two vectors is 0. Hence x bar minus c bar is parallel to b bar. Parallel to b bar. Cross product of parallel vectors is 0 bar. Since these two are parallel, therefore x bar minus c bar equal to some scalar t into b bar, where t be a scalar. Scalar or a real number. X bar minus C bar equal to T B bar. Now, given X dot A is 0, hence, now, taking dot product with A bar, X bar dot A bar minus C bar dot A bar equal to T into b bar dot c bar, a bar. I am taking dot product with a bar on both sides. X dot a minus c dot a equal to t into b dot a, but x dot a is 0, equal to minus c dot a equal to t into b dot a. So I will evaluate t as minus c dot a by b dot a. This is a scalar and this is also a scalar. Hence t becomes a scalar. Therefore x equal to x bar minus c bar equal to t minus of c dot a by b dot a into b bar, since t is this one. Therefore x bar, you can write it as minus c dot a by b dot a multiplied b bar. That means x bar may be written in terms of a bar, b bar, c bar and their dot product. C bar minus c dot a by b dot a multiplied b bar. Such questions may expect to mains. Next one. Next problem. If u bar equal to a bar minus b bar, b bar equal to a bar plus b bar, and modulus of a bar equal to modulus of b bar equal to 2, then u bar cross v bar is u bar cross v bar in terms of a and b. Here the options are twice to that of 16 minus a bar dot b bar whole square. square root of 16 minus a dot b whole square. The third one is twice to the top 4 minus a dot b whole square. Fourth one is square root of 4 minus a dot b whole square. Both u bar equal to a bar minus b bar. B bar is a bar plus b bar. Mod a bar equal to mod b bar equal to 2. Then u cross v. So this is u bar equal to a bar minus b bar. V bar equal to a bar plus b bar. Okay. We know that u bar cross v bar is square plus u bar dot v bar square equal to mod u bar square mod v bar square. This is our relation. Mod u bar square mod v bar square. So therefore u bar cross v bar whole square takes the value mod u bar square mod v bar square minus u bar dot v bar square. Now so therefore I will consider u dot v here, u dot v this value u dot v is a bar minus b bar dot a bar minus b bar plus, taking the dot product here we get mod a bar square mod b bar square. This is 4 minus 4 because mod a bar is 2, mod b bar is 2, 0. Hence this term is 0. Therefore u bar cross v bar is equal to mod u bar mod b bar, because it becomes 0. Once it becomes 0, this is the product of mod u bar into mod v bar. That is obtained by modulus of a bar plus b bar into modulus of a bar minus b bar. Modulus of a bar plus b bar minus modulus of a bar minus b bar itself. But modulus of a bar plus b bar square is mod a square plus mod b square plus 2 a dot b. Similarly mod a bar minus b bar square is mod a square plus mod b square minus 2 a dot b. Therefore modulus of a bar plus b bar square equal to, this is 4 plus 4 8 8 plus 2 a dot b. Similarly mod a bar plus minus b bar square is 8 minus 2 a bar dot b bar. Hence this is this value. Therefore u bar cross v bar is modulus of a bar plus b bar is square root of 8 plus 2 a dot b into of course 8 minus 2 a dot b. That is under the square root we get 64 minus 4 into a dot b whole square, which is taking 4 as common we get 2 into square root of 16 minus a dot b whole square. So twice to the top 16 minus a dot b whole square is the required value. Next. Next one. Next, based on cross products, this is one important problem. The vector I cross A dot B bar into I plus J cross A dot B bar into J plus K cross A dot B bar into K is equal to first one B cross A, second one A cross, third one A cross B, and fourth one is B bar. If R bar is any vector, then I dot R bar multiplied I plus J dot R bar multiplied J, K dot R bar multiplied K is always equal to R bar. This is one important relation, because R bar, once you take R bar as xi plus yj plus zk, then I dot R bar is just x, J dot R bar is y, K dot R bar is z. So this is xi, yj, zk. Again we get R bar. That is one important point. If R bar is any vector, then I dot R bar into I plus J dot R bar into J plus K dot R bar into K equal to R bar itself. So based on this, so I cross A bar dot B bar into I plus J cross A bar dot B into C plus K cross A bar dot B bar into K may be written as, the positions of dot and cross can be interchanged here. So taking the product of these two, cross product of these two, you can write this value as this into I. If in the expression, if dot and cross is involved, you can interchange the positions of dot and cross without changing the order of the vectors. Here I am not changing the order of the vectors, I A B itself. Without changing the order of the vectors, you can change the positions of dot and cross. Similarly here, J dot A bar cross B bar J, K dot A bar cross B bar K, which is clearly in this form. So therefore this is equal to A bar cross B bar itself. Instead of R bar, this is R bar. So this, hence we get R bar. That means A bar cross B bar. I am using this one, this point. This is one important point. Okay. Of course, this is scalar triple product. In scalar triple product, you can interchange dot and cross. That is the point, Wathanot point here. Next one. Next. Let A bar is J minus K. B bar is, C bar. C bar is I minus J minus K. Then vector B bar satisfying A bar cross B bar plus C bar equal to 0 bar and A bar dot B bar is 3. Yes. A bar is J minus K. C bar is I minus J plus minus K. Then the vector B bar satisfying A cross B plus C bar and A dot B equal to 3 is. Okay. B bar and this is B dot B C square cross product A dot B is given. Okay. So the options are here. Actual the options are 2i minus A plus 2k I minus A minus 2k. The third one is I plus A minus plus 2k. And fourth one is, of course, this is minus 2k. And minus I plus J minus 2k. Of course, you can observe A dot B as 3 and pick up the answer. That is one procedure. Immediate procedure. Dot product of A bar, this is B bar. So, dot product must be equal to 3. Observe. For which the dot product, for which vector the dot product with A bar is 3. That is easiest method here. One more procedure is here. A bar cross B bar plus C bar is 0. Therefore, A bar cross B bar takes the value minus C bar. Modulus of A bar cross B bar whole square is modulus of A bar cross B bar whole square equal to mod C bar square. But this is mod A bar square mod B bar square minus A bar dot B bar square is mod C square. Okay. Mod A bar, this is root 2 square. Into this is not known to us, but this is 3, so 3 square. This is mod c bar is root 3 square. From this we get mod c b bar equal to 3 plus 9, 12 by 2, that is 6 square, and this is square. Mod b bar square is 6, mod b bar square is 6. So that is possible only for this one, because mod b bar equal to root 6. Clearly that is possible only for 4 plus 1 plus 1. Of course this is 3. 4 plus 1 plus 1 6, 4 plus 1 plus 1 6. Out of these 3, the answer is here. Okay. Now observe for which vector out of this was nullified, this was not the answer because modulus of B bar is root 6 here. So that out of these 3, taking the dot product with A bar, now consider J minus K dot I minus j minus 2k verification, just I am a verification. This is 0 of course minus 1 plus 2, 1 not equal to 3. So hence this is not the answer. Similarly j minus k dot I plus j minus 2k, that is 1 minus 2, 3. It may be the answer. Next one is 1 plus 4, 5. So this is the answer, because its magnitude is root 6, as well as the dot product with a bar is 3. So by verification method you can pick up the answer I plus j minus 2k itself. Next, this is already the area of parallelogram. Area of parallelogram whose diagonal or along the vectors 8i minus 6j and 3i plus 4j minus 12k is the area of the parallelogram whose diagonals are along the vectors 8i minus 6j and 3i plus 4j minus 12k. For the vectors, if the diagonals are d1 bar, d2 bar, area of parallelogram is half modulus of d1 bar cross d2 bar. So here d1 is, d1 bar is of course 8i minus 6j plus 0k. D2 bar is 3i plus 4j minus 12k. Therefore, D1 bar cross D2 bar is determinant of ijk 8 minus 6, 0, 3, 4 minus 12. Taking the cross product of these two, we get 72 minus 0. So, 72i. Next, minus j into, this is minus 96, minus 96, minus minus 96 minus 0, j, plus 32 minus plus 18, 32 plus 18, 50, okay. That is 72i plus 96j plus 50k. So area required, area is 1 by 2 modulus of 72i plus 96j plus 50k, that is 1 by 2 into square root of 72 square plus 96 square plus 50 square. On simplification we get the area, the required area. Of course, you can take 4 as common, 2 as common, once 2 square is 4, 4 as common here, 36 square, 48 square, 25 square, like that. On evaluation, we get the required area. Okay. Next problem. Of course, this is, it comes under if A bar, comma B bar and C bar are unit vectors. Unit vectors such that A bar plus B bar plus C bar is 0 bar and angle between A and B is pi by 3, then mod A bar cross B bar, mod B bar cross C bar, mod C bar cross A bar equal to. If A bar, B bar, C bar are unit vectors such that the sum of the vectors is 0 bar and angle between AB is pi by 3, then A cross B plus B cross C plus C cross A bar. Okay. A bar plus B bar plus C bar is 0 bar. A bar plus B bar plus C bar is 0 bar. This is A bar plus B bar equal to minus C bar. Therefore, squaring. Squaring on both sides, we get mod A bar square plus mod B bar square plus twice to that of A dot B is mod C square. That is 1 plus 1 plus 2 mod A bar mod B bar cos of angle between A and B is mod C square. That is also 1. So therefore, this is 1 1 cos pi by 3, that cos pi by 3 is here. Okay, it is valid, of course, that is not the procedure here. Of course, it is valid. Now, taking cross product. That implies taking cross product with C bar, A bar plus B bar plus C bar cross C bar is 0 bar cross C bar. That is A bar cross C bar, B bar cross C bar, C cross C is 0 bar. But C cross C is also 0 bar. So A cross C plus B cross C equal to 0 bar, since C cross C is 0. Therefore, B cross C takes the value minus A cross C bar, which is C cross A itself, interchanging these two. B cross C is equal to C cross A. Therefore, modulus of B cross C is same that of modulus of C cross A. Similarly, taking cross product with B bar, we get 0 bar cross B bar, which is A bar cross B bar plus B cross B is 0 plus C cross B is 0 bar itself. So A bar cross B bar takes the value minus C cross B, which is B cross C itself. Hence, modulus of A cross B is same that of B cross C. from these two. Therefore, modulus of A bar cross B bar, modulus of B bar cross C bar plus modulus of C bar cross A bar is thrice to that of A bar cross B bar. Because these two are equal. Thrice to that of mod A bar cross B bar. Now I will find, but modulus of A bar cross B bar equal to square root of mod A square mod B square minus A dot B whole square. Okay, this is 1 square minus dot product is cos pi by 3 whole square, because mod A bar is 1, mod B bar is 1. So this is 2 minus 1 by 4, root 7 by 2. This value is root 7 by 2. So the required value is 3 into root 7 by 3 root 7 by 2. The required value A bar cross B bar cross C bar cross C bar is, this is 1, of course this is not 2, this is 1 only, 3 by 2, root 3 by 2, hence this is root 3, 3 root 3 by 2. The required value is 3 root 3 by 2. This is one fine problem given in MCET related to the cross and dot products. Based on this rule, you can take this problem.